Welcome to this SSIS tutorial on how to export data from SQL Server to Excel. So the first step before importing or exporting any data from SQL Server to Excel or from Excel to SQL Server is to check that you have the proper drivers installed on your computer. So in my case, I'm using a Windows 10 Professional 64 bytes, and you simply need to go to the Microsoft download page to install the drivers, and I will paste the link on the description of the video. So you need to select the first option, which is the name. The file name is access database engine.exe, because you want to use the 32 bytes version of the file. This is because Visual Studio 2019 or Visual Studio in general works as a 32 bytes software. We'll do a more detailed video on this topic, because there is some configuration issues, because you also have the drivers from your Office installation, Microsoft Office installation, that is in 64 bytes. The second step is to prepare the SQL Server table in order to load some data into it and export this data. So we'll just open SQL Server Management Studio, SSMS, and create a table, sample table, with a few lines, 24 lines. And the goal of the tutorial is to export this data in the Excel file without any error and in a repeatable way, because of course you can run a package as many times as you want. So we just open SSMS, you open a database where you have access, a development database or a database where you can play, and you simply check that first that you don't have this table. This table is not existing in your database. If it's the case, you just drop the table. Of course, you need to be sure what you do. You don't do that in a production environment, of course. And you just execute the first create table statement. Then you execute the insert into statement. So we just inserted 24 lines in the table called dbo.customers. Now let's check the content of the table to make sure that we have this data available in our database. So you just run a select star from customers, you click on execute, and here you have 24 rows of data. And in the next steps, we are going to see how to configure the SSIS package in order to export this data into an Excel file. And just to check, so we have four columns: the customer ID, the first name, last name, the city and the country. And you can check that we have as many lines as the IDs that are available. In the step two, we just prepared, we created a SQL Server table. And in step three, the goal is to prepare the target Excel file. So to do that, there is something very important that you need to know, is that it's all about the structure of the data. When you do data integration using SSIS or any other tool, it's all about the structure. So to make it much more simple, you need to make sure that you have the same column names and the same data structure in the source and the target. So to do that, you just go back to your SSMS, you just copy one line, you select the option copy with headers, and the goal is just to have the exact same names in our table and in our Excel file. So you just remove the data line, don't take it into consideration, just copy the headers. So we have the five columns: customer ID, first name, last name, city and country. You make it, we do a little bit of formatting here. So this very first line will be the header of our Excel table. And we really have exactly the same column names as in the table. This is very important, especially in bigger projects with a lot of columns, because we use these names to do automatic mapping in SSIS packages. So you just save the Excel file, I'm using Windows 10 Professional, so I just have a folder called data at the my C drive, and you just save the file. So you just browse to an existing location. Actually, it will be much better. So here we go, C data, and that's it. So you just save the file. We have one line with the header, and that's it. You save it and you can close it. That's it for step three. Step four is the actual creation of the SSIS package. So you just close the Excel file. You can open now any solution that you have or any SSIS project that you already have. So to do that, you just open Visual Studio 2019. You create a project and the solution. I have other videos on how to do that on the channel. I will paste the link also in the description. So I'm just closing whatever package I had open previously. And I'm going to go to the Solution Explorer and create a new package. So I will show you from scratch how to do from the control flow to the data flow, to the connections, to the database and to the file. So as you may know, a package is composed of levels, let's say. And the higher one is the control flow. And inside the control flow, you have the data flow, which is the main level or the main component, the most important component on any SSIS data integration project. So I just created a package called Package Excel Export. So I advise you to make package names very explicit. Once you have created the package, we go now to the control flow, and now we need to install or to just to display the SSIS toolbox, because by default, sometime, depending on what language you are developing using Visual Studio, it doesn't show automatically. So you just go to View, Other Windows, and you select SSIS toolbox, and then you will have the SSIS toolbox in the left. So you can do a custom setup. For example, I have my Visual Studio in black or in dark mode, because I think it's much more convenient for the eyes. And you can also configure where the components are. For example, if I was using some of them, they become in the favorite section. So you can make them go back to their original section, like common or containers or other tasks, for example. But here we are going to use the data flow task, which is a very, certainly one of the most used tasks in SSIS, because it's all about data integration and data and moving data from a source to a target, whether it's a file or a database, or it can be a flat file, an XML file, an Excel file. So here you go. So you have your data flow ready. So you can just double click on it. So inside the data flow, now we are going to use two different components. So for the source, we are going to use the OLE DB Source, which is kind of a generic component to connect to multiple databases supporting OLE DB drivers. And the second one will be the target, and we're going to use the Excel destination. So as you can guess by its name, it's dedicated to Excel files, and it's made especially for that. So we are not choosing in this tutorial any transformation in between, because we just want to take the data from the SQL Server table and insert it or export it into the Excel file as it is. So we just want the 24 rows to be exported into the Excel file. Here we go. Step six is how to configure the source component, which is the OLE DB source. by its name in SSIS. So I don't rename it, but you know you can rename any component into in SSIS in the package. So as you can see, we have two red crosses in both components. So the goal here will be to configure a connection manager, because you need to reuse the connection. You cannot configure it directly into it. It is really every component has to use a connection manager when it's about exporting or reading data. So we already have one, so I'm going to delete it so we can redo it all together. So you see how it goes. So you just click on new. You select, you can keep by default the SQL Server native client 11.0. So for information, I'm using a SQL Server 2019 installed in my laptop. So it's the server name is localhost. I'm using also the Windows authentication, so I don't have to provide any username or password. And the source database is expert only. So you just select the database. Something very important now is that you need to test the connection to avoid errors later in the development. Okay, so we have a successful connection. You just validate your connection manager. And that's it for this step. Now we can go now to the source component and configure it. So it will be, so per default it's using directly this connection because it's the only one available, and you can just select the table. So here it's customers, dbo.customers, and now you can see the columns. So as we can see, we have our five columns available: customer ID, first name, last name, city and country. So it's all good for the source component. And as you can see now, the red cross is not there anymore because the connection is okay. The step seven is now to configure the target component, which is the connection to the Excel file and the mapping of the data from the source to the target. So we need to create a new connection manager. So you just right click on the connection manager section. You select new connection manager, and then you select Excel. So it's a dedicated connection manager for Excel files. You just click add, and now you simply select, or you just copy paste the path of your Excel file, so which is C data, employees, or customers, sorry, customers dot underscore export dot xlsx. And here we're going to select, you need to select that the first row has headers because we just created this first row. Here I'm selecting the 2007-2010 version of Excel, because otherwise you might have some problems if you select the newer version. And then you can rename, of course, the name of the connection manager to be more explicit. So I suggest to have the same name as the Excel file. Now you open the component Excel destination. You select the sheet. So by default, there's just one, so it's selected. You cannot be wrong on that one. And so you just select the first one. You can check also the existing data from the file. And now you go to the mapping tab and you just make sure that that all the columns are mapped properly. So this is the step I was talking to you about. It's all about naming the columns. It's all about that. So when you have the exact same name between the source and the target, the mapping is done automatically. And you can also right click on the component and select map columns automatically. So that's it. Now we have both components without any red cross and we are ready to launch the package. Now we are going to perform the last step, which is to run the SSIS package and check the result in the Excel file. And to do that, you just go to the Visual Studio interface and then you select start or you click on F5. So just to do a quick check before, we are going to open the Excel file to make sure it's empty for now. And we, as we can see, we only have our line of header with the five columns. And that's it. We don't have any other data to the Excel file. Just close it. And before you run the package, you need to make sure that the package, if you want to use the F5 or even the start button, you need to make sure that it is set as the startup object. Because by default, an SSIS project runs one object first, because you cannot run all packages at once or something like that, because SSIS packages are made to be run one by one. And now, as you can see, it's all green, so we don't have any error. We have a few warnings about performance DLL. And that's it. So it's very important to make sure that the warnings are not about data or data formats, because you can have problems when you do a large scale project. And now we are going to check the result. You go back to the folder where you have the Excel file, you just click on it, and we should have 24 lines with the exact same content as the SQL Server table. And here we go, so we have the five columns. We have a warning for the first one because of the number stored as text, which is a classical Excel problem. We might cover also this one in another video. And so that's it for the tutorial. I will provide all the links, the SSI links, and also the link to the article with all the scripts or screenshots about this tutorial on our blog. So that's it for this one.